Hello everyone, welcome to BIMModeler.com. This is Raj. In this video tutorial, you'll be learning HVAC systems, what is HVAC systems, and purpose of HVAC system in a building, and what are the types available in the HVAC systems. You'll also learn what are the equipments available, the most popular equipments available with the systems, and we will be having the exercise at the end of the session. With that, what is HVAC? HVAC is a heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. It's an acronym. In a building, we are not living in the same place, so the situation of the environment varies place to place, and the conditions are like temperature. It varies place to place. If you are in a north side, you'll have a more cold temperatures. If you are in south side, you may have feel like in a earth, in earth you will have a higher temperatures. So whenever it requires, based on the seasons, we have to adjust the temperature in our ACs. We know that, so that is heating. It may be a heating or cooling in a building. So ventilations, for example, in your toilet or in your building kitchens, you may have to take some ventilations. You have to give some ventilation, proper ventilation, so that you will be able to work in the workplace. Workplace may be a bedroom, or it may be a place that you are working in. So it may be anything, the space that needs to be properly ventilated. Air conditioning, so we have to condition air, such as quality of the air we have to maintain. So we will be do some conditions, such as, so what is the purpose of HVAC? You will be understanding to help maintain good indoor air quality through adequate ventilation with filtration and provide thermal comfort to the person who is in the space. So the air quality may be a temperature, humidity, purity of the filtering, so purity of the air, air flow rate, and the fresh air. Sometimes we need a fresh air from the outside environment. So how we are controlling those? So these things will be controlled in the systematic manner, which is called HVAC. That's the purpose of HVAC. Standards. So there are majorly people using ASHRAE. So they say ASHRAE, A-S-H-R-A-E. So it's an American standard. So you have to be adopt with American standards. Most of the countries uses it, and they may have their own standards based on the countries. ISRAE is the Indian country standards. So in India, so we have to follow this ISRAE. So other country and state codes also we have to follow for this HVAC design, and the designer will follow those codes, and they will define the design criteria and building requirement. Based on that, they will define the designs of the HVAC. So in this, you have to learn what is ASHRAE and ISRAE. So what are the other standards available in the market? So in the countries they use, the countries that you watching, so you have to check that what the country that you are in, what are the standards they follow. Let me know what country you are in and what standards that you are following. And types of HVAC systems, what are the types? There are basically two things that are available. You may see them like local, central. There are two things. The local systems are such as, you may have seen it, split AC, window AC, which is called local system. And the central systems are all air based system, all water based system, air water based systems. Basically they are categorized as like this. They will have such as VAV systems, FCU systems, fan coil unit, FCU, VAV, variable air volume systems you may have in your building or in your office or the place that you are working or in your college or school. So the local also categorized as a local heating. So some buildings may require only the heating, some buildings may require only the cooling. For India, where I am residing, so it requires only the most of the yearly, most of the time, so it requires only the coolings. So local ventilations, so local you may have to have ventilation, so in that case you can go with the local systems instead of doing it multiple places. You can go with central systems. So there are cost and time and maintenance purpose. We split that into our two things, local and central. Hope everybody knows a split AC condition. So the split AC consists of two units, which is outdoor unit and indoor unit. Every process happens in the outdoor unit, the cooling process and compression intense the thing, and the indoor air unit will supply the air via the cooling coil, so automatically the room will be cooled. But the problem is that you don't have any fresh air to the room, because it's for a single room. You may not have a fresh air requirements. There are some requirements, fresh air and the filtering and the thickness of the air. There are more requirement based on the space. The space may be a hospital building, space may be a emergency room, hospital in the emergency room, or in a hospital operation theater. Each place requires a unique requirement of the air. So we have to control them in a way that it requires. So in a central air conditioning space, we have to have proper systems, like in a one place, in a controlled environment, everything will be controlled and then it will be sent to the other places. All air system. What is all air system? If you see that there are zone A and zone B. So this is a room that you can say, and this room will be supplied with the one air terminal with the VAV box. The VAV box is controlled by the sensor, the temperature sensor, which gives the temperature to the VAV box automatically. It gives the controlled how much air it's supposed to be supplied to the room. On the other side, if you see that the air goes out in the return or exhaust, whatever the system that it is connected. So now it is a return system actually. So it's connected to the return back to the place. So what is there? So it's a centralized AHQ unit. In the AHQ unit, everything happens in one place. It means heating, filtering, and other quality controlling will be happening in the one place. So air handling unit, it handles all the things. It supplies the air to the room and it will be supplied to room. It may be heating or cooling. So once based on the requirement, the temperature requirement, it will be supplied to the room and it comes back to the out of the room. So if you see the inside room, it only the heating or it may be a cooling, it controlled only by the air. So because of that, we call this as all air systems. Nothing happening with the water in the room. So in that case, water will be supplied only in the cooling coil or heating coil in this place, so not inside this space. So everything will be controlled in the central manner and it is not as split systems. In a water system, if you see that inside the zone, if you see each room inside the zone, and the water goes in and out, the medium of supply in this place, it is water or maybe any coolant which is in the water format and which is supplied by the pipe. In the previous case, the air will be supplied by the duct systems, which is a duct rectangle or round shape, or in this place it is supplied by the pipe. It may be any water, most probably water, or the processed any chemical liquid that passes through these pipes. It will be controlled, the valve will be actuated, so it will be controlled by the thermostat inside the room. The pipe goes in to the coils, FCU maybe, or cooling air terminal with the cooling coil. So it goes in and comes out and return to the system, main system. So based on the medium of temperature transfer, we call it as air system or water system. What passes into the room, so we say that air system or water system. So what is the difference? The difference is that air have a lesser density, water have the higher density. So the element which carries the higher density will able to carry temperatures, withhold the temperatures. So it requires very minimum space. So for a pipe system, all water system, it requires very less space, but in a duct system it requires more space as compared with the pipe systems. So in a building, it may, based on that, in a building we may require air water based systems or water based system. It depends on the availability. In a air based system, you will be able to control air humidity in the same system, but in a pipe system you cannot control the a humidity in the same system, you have to apply the another system for controlling the humidity. For that purpose, in a some building, if you have more space, you can use the duct system also, pipe system also, it means air water system. So the humidity also can be controlled in the same place, and you can reduce some of the place by using the pipe system by transferring the temperature through the water medium. So in that case, we will be going with air water system. This is the basic three type of systems available in the market as of now. The people are using it, but the system may classify further based on the equipment used, based on the control system used, based on these supply the air or water supplied to the space. Based on that, it varies in a multiple ways. So if you are a designer, we'll be discussing that later time. Stay tuned. So if you need anything clarity on these topics, you can leave a comment. I will try to add those videos later on. Thank you. What are the equipments? So I have listed most of the equipments, the most used equipments. There are more equipments available in the required systems, but we may have to look into these elements like air filter, which filters the air, fan, which is supplies the air to the room or to the space, outdoor intake and terminal devices, which ends with the air, heating and cooling coils, the coil which supplies the heating or cooling to the room. So the air will pass through the coil, automatically it absorbs the heating or cooling temperature. Self-contained heating and cooling unit and cooling tower, which is on the used to cool down the medium of supply of water. Boiler, so it used to heat the medium. Control, so it may be any control, thermostat control, or any system that controls the valve or damper or any elements. Water chiller, humidification and dehumidification equipments, so it's used to control the humidity of the room. VAV equipment, variable air volume, it controls the volume of air which supplies to the room. Damper, so there are different dampers available, automatic and manuals are most used, and you will be able to control manually and automatically, which is similar to this one in this place. So that's it. So you have to learn from this session. So you have to learn what are the HVAC equipments are there and how do they work. Try to watch some videos and images. It will help you to remember in while working with the Revit projects. So as I said, this is not a design project. So we are going to do a modeling in Revit. So these basics topics will help you to learn something. So give a like and share it with your learning friends. Thank you so much. See you on the next tutorial.